Hi, David Weck here, and I'm coming to you from S10 Fitness in San Diego, and today I'm going to teach you a tip on how to improve your overhand throwing motion with both sides. The overhand throwing motion is a very athletic move that requires a complete tie-in from hands down to feet, and if we learn to do it with both sides of the body, we can become far more athletic. And it's just another fun way to exercise as well. So I'm using the RMT club. That stands for Rotational Movement Training. I'm using the audible feedback and the tactile feedback of this to make the patterns powerful and precise. So to start it out, there's three basic positions. Position one is club vertical, and I let the weight shift into that position. Position two, I simply bring it behind the head, again, vertical, and I let it shift into that position. Now I rotate 90 degrees, and I bring the club over. So I've got a simple one, two, three. Paint by numbers, and now I start to pick up the pace on that. So it's catch, catch, catch. And then I take it and make it centrifugal where I don't want to hear the club now. I've patterned the move, so I've got those points that I want to hit, and now I make it fluid and connected. Tie it into the core, drill it down through the feet. Okay, that's the dominant side. You can feel the joints nice and juiced up, and I'm starting to lay down a connection that's going to translate into a better, powerful throw with cleaner action through the joints. Non-dominant time. Here we go. Paint by numbers. One, two, three. Take as many repetitions on the non-dominant side as necessary to make it come off. What I like to do as well, and what I'll do with clients, is I'll say, okay, you've done three with the non-dominant side. Go back to the dominant so that you can really feel what it feels like, what you know how to do. And now let's put it into that non-dominant side. I want you to have no bias as an athlete as to which side you're gonna use. So, got that baseline, speed it up. So it's one, two, three. And now take out all the sound, make it flow. Boom, and feel that strength and balance. Boom, boom, boom. And you just go back and forth. Dominant side, non-dominant side. Paint by numbers, make it perfect. So it's slow is smooth, smooth is fast approach. Now there's obvious physical benefits to doing this. And how I would do it with a client is I'd have them do squats or lunges or something. I'd come and I'd recover by doing this exercise because I'm not gonna get them doing it fast at first. But there's also a mental benefit because this hand is controlled by this side of the brain and this hand by this side of the brain. And when I start creating this ambidextrous action where both sides are capable of flowing and moving with the same kind of balance and precision, I create a better resonance or harmony within the brain. It can actually lead to better thinking. So obviously you want to do it for the athletic benefits, but it's a nice side benefit that your brain starts to think better too. And as an athlete, it's the totality. It's every cell within your body contributing to your performance. And that's your body and it's your brain and it's unification that we want. So that's overhand throwing motion. We can modify by choking up, change it, go a little bit higher here, here, to just lay the patterns. Come to weckmethod.com to find out more. David Weck, signing off from S10 Fitness.